The light-dependent reactions of photosynthesis take place in the thylakoids. Light energy powers the formation of two types of high-energy compounds. One compound is NADPH, and the other is ATP. The plant cell uses the energy in these compounds during the second phase of photosynthesis, called the Calvin cycle. The Calvin cycle takes place in the fluid stroma surrounding the thylakoids. Each turn of the Calvin cycle builds one small subunit that leaves the loop. These small subunits are the building blocks for sugars and starches. The starting compound for the Calvin cycle is a 5-carbon compound called RuBP. During the first step of the cycle, one molecule of carbon dioxide is added to each of 3 RuBP molecules. The plant absorbs carbon dioxide from the surrounding air. The 3 RuBPs become 6 carbon molecules. Each of these molecules splits in half, forming 6 3-carbon molecules called PGA. 6 ATPs must be spent to energize the 6 PGAs. Then, 6 NADPHs must be spent to energize the PGAs still further. These 3-carbon molecules are now called PGAL. Of the 6 PGALs formed, 5 remain in the Calvin cycle while 1 exits. As the cycle continues, the 5 PGALs rearrange back into 3 molecules of 5-carbon RuBP. This requires 3 more ATPs. Each turn of the Calvin cycle, the 5-carbon RuBPs accept carbon dioxide molecules. 6 new PGALs form at the cost of ATPs and NADPHs. A PGAL molecule leaves the cycle, and the 5-carbon starting material is regenerated. The PGAL that left the Calvin cycle moves out of the chloroplast and into the plant cell's cytoplasm. Once in the cytoplasm, the PGAL can be combined with another PGAL into a 6-carbon glucose molecule or other sugar.